Greetings to all excellences. This is Yash Sharma of Kendriya Vidyalaya Sector 12 Dwarka, New Delhi. Without wasting time, I would like to directly come on the topic. That is heat management system, a frugal approach. Today, India is developing and one can trace its development by just a single word. That is internet. Yes, today we use internet 24/7. This is due to the help of so many supercomputers and satellites and moreover DC servers. Now, what are DC servers? DC servers are the data centers which comprises of so many supercomputers working on to provide day-to-day services to all of us. Now, this is general knowledge and seriously, we are not here to discuss GK. But what if I'll add a tinge of seriousness by adding the facts? That is, you will get amazed to know that on an average, around 4 lakh joules of heat energy. Yes, 4 lakh joules of heat energy is produced by one supercomputer one day. Now, this is not just one thing in the list of generation of waste heat. There are a lot of culprits left out. So, we have made a machine for the management of that waste heat into electricity. So now let's hunt for the places or devices which generate this reckless waste heat in the grassroots level, that is our school. You can find these things in offices, in industrial sector where there are a lot of due capacity things, in streets and even in space, that is satellites. So let our hunt begin. Cars, sounds nice, but this is the first place of our hunting. Cars, this is the menace in the category of generation of waste heat. It gives out so much amount of heat. Have you ever kept your ass in the bonnet of a car? Seems funny, but it's scientifically the truth. We can put a machine in the bonnet of the car or in the engine so as to provide it coolness and order to generate electricity. So now let's hunt for the second place of our machine. Now, we are on our next place. But what is the thing we are hunting for? This is the damn piece of metal that is an AC. You think AC just gives you cooling, but on the other side, it just kills the surrounding by its heatness. Now, I've just traveled 10 steps, as you can see here, and we have found another AC. Now, this clearly signifies that how much amount of ACs we have and ultimately how much waste heat we are producing in our Mother Earth. Therefore, it is our second place of hunting. Therefore, we have found a direction to which we can proceed and make a device which can manage, we can seriously convert that waste heat into electricity of ACs, refrigerators, supercomputers, rockets, satellites, blah 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 and other heavy electronics. Ultimately, we have made a noble way of lightning fast electricity generation device which can convert the waste heat into electricity. Sounds nice, right? So let's take a look to our innovation. Hello everyone, once again. So this is the setup of our project, heat management system, a frugal approach. So basically we have made 4 units in our machine which can manage that waste heat into electricity. Now these are so much steps through which we can do this. So first of all, I'd like to explain whether we have done the experiment. So in our experiment, it is like a spark, it's like a revolution in the management of that waste heat. So we have made a spark, HMS. As you can see here, the diagram, we have its practical version also, we will explain you further. It is a practical approach to be familiar with the Seebeck effect and Peltier module. Now, what is Seebeck effect? So, Seebeck effect, I will explain you by the help of the poster. Seebeck effect is an effect which is used in thermocouple plates. Now, this is an effect. If we provide heat on and cold on each of its sides of a thermocouple plate, it will generate electricity. Now, what is a thermocouple plate? So, basically, a thermocouple plate is this. Thermocouple plate is a device which is used to check the cooling, to measure the temperature. But now we have used here the inverse of Seebeck effect. The inverse of Seebeck effect states that if you will provide temperature fluctuations, that is heat and cool on each of its sides of the thermocouple plate, it will give you electricity. So we have used this principle in our machine heat management system. So first of all, we have done an experiment by using simple iron rods, by providing it heat through the spirit lamp and using a tag box, that is thermoelectric generator box. So this is a sample tag box which we have used in the regional levels. Tag box, there we have 4 thermocouple plates used. We will give cooling through this side and heat on this on. Sorry, we will give heat on this side and cooling on this side. By that temperature fluctuations, we will generate electricity. So I will be doing its practical version now. So this is a spirit lamp, as we cannot bring a supercomputer or any other thing here. So
So I've provided it cooling now. I have to give its height, little bit height. So now, here we can use dry ice or CO2, solid dry ice or CO2, or we can use here coolants or liquid nitrogen. The best thing is liquid nitrogen. As it has a temperature of minus 196 degrees Celsius, liquid nitrogen will be best suited. But here we have used coolant because liquid nitrogen is very much hazardous for us. So we will be giving it cooling now in this way. Now we will connect it through a multimeter which can show whether we are generating electricity or not. Basically, it will take 2.5 minutes to generate a continuous electricity. Now, as you can see here, it is generating 0.39, 0.38, 0.29 volts of electricity. Just a second now. Yes. It will clearly specify now. By the temperature fluctuations, we are giving heat and cool on each of its sides. It is generating electricity. Now, this is a certain thing. As you can see here, this is following the principle of Seebeck effect. If we are giving heat on from the lower side and cold surface on the upper side, and this due to this temperature fluctuations, we are generating electricity. So this effect, we have done this approach so as to get familiar with the Seebeck effect, whether it will work in our day-to-day life purposes or not. So we have done the experiment now. So after doing the experiment, we have made a modified HMS, that is modified heat management system. Now, as you can see in the figure, we have made a device for the management of that waste heat in supercomputers or in any other heavy appliances. You have to add it. So as you can see here, we have used thermocouple plates in the middle of two aluminium plates, and this is the place through which we can give it cooling. As you can see here, we have made a box here, and this is the aluminium plate. This is through which we can give it cooling, and heat will be given to this side. We can simply put this in any of the machine, in any of the heavy appliances. Now, as you can see here, the generation of electricity is 732. This is not continuous. This is not steady because there is a difference in the temperature fluctuations. It is not constant temperature fluctuations. So, our main motto is to generate, to see that electricity is being generated. So, I will close this now. As you can see, it is dropping. Okay. So hence our practical approach has been satisfied by using this tag box and Seebeck effect. This will be hot, so I'll place it on the other side. Just a second. Now, coming to our new version, that is modified HMS, which can be directly put in each and every machine. Here, this is a lab thermometer. We will check the temperature. Now putting the cooling. And one more thing, it is efficient than the practical one because we have used here 6 thermocouple plates. In that we have used 4 thermocouple plates. In this we have used 6 thermocouple plates of different type. Now what are the different types? What specifies its different types? I'll explain you just a second. As you can see here, there are different types of thermocouple plates, like type K, which has a maximum temperature of 1260 degrees Celsius, minimum temperature of minus 270 degrees Celsius. So there are different types of thermocouple plates. Here we have used type J thermocouple plates, which have a 760 and minus 210 degrees Celsius limit. And in that we have used type E, which has a low limit of that generation of electricity. So these are the different types of thermocouple plates we have used in our modified HMS and the spark HMS. So now we have given cooling. Now I will be giving it. Now after 2.5 minutes, we have put it cooling and heat. As you can see here, we have been providing it continuous heat from the spirit lamp. And as you can see here, the multimeter reading, it is 2.37 volts of electricity. Now this is too much because we are not giving it a temperature, continuous temperature. We are not giving it a continuous temperature fluctuating. So I have done in useful lab. Uh, sorry, I've done in labs, and there I have been getting a volt of 2 volts to 11 volts. As you can see in the last point, production range achieved is 2 volts to 11 volts. This is done in the practical labs. So as you can see here, in the direct implementation, we can have its maximum benefit. Now, this is like we have done this. Now, what about the things that we can directly, you know, we cannot directly put that in a car, in a bonnet of a car or any other thing. So we have made a DWAR box, D-E-W-A-R. It is not like Amitabh Bachchan's film DWAR. It's like DWAR box, D-E-W-A-R. It is made up of DWAR, glass type, DWAR is a glass type, and it can store liquid nitrogen in it. Yes, it is able to store liquid nitrogen in it, and we have attached a stainless steel here. As you can see, it is a good conductor of coldness, and we will be directly putting a thermocouple plate in between the other stainless steel and the liquid nitrogen, and we will be directly putting in any of the surfaces where heat is released. So suppose if this is a surface where heat is being released and heat is getting dissipated through this. This is a thermocouple. This is a like a supercomputer, and we have put this. Just a second. We have put this as follows. So heat will be given to this thermocouple plate through this stainless steel, and coldness will be given through this liquid nitrogen. We will put the liquid nitrogen as it is hazardous. We are not able to use it. We are not permitted to use it. So by this temperature fluctuance, we will use electricity. So as you can see, we have made 4 units. I've shown you 3 units. We have made actually 4 units. I will show you the another one. We have made till now we have made 3 units for the management of that waste heat in different appliances, like ACs, like refrigerators. We can put this in AC and refrigerator. We can put that in supercomputer. And that was in a practical approach which I have described through that poster. Now, what about the fourth one? Have you ever wondered about ICs getting hot? Yes, ICs do get hot. Integrated circuits. So to use that integrated circuits, we have made a thermocouple plate attached with heat sink. As you can see here, we have a sample heat sink also here. So we have attached a heat sink onto a thermocouple plate. So it will directly use that heat and coldness through the surrounding, and by that temperature fluctuance, it will be directly generating electricity from the integrated circuit. So this is like going to a grassroots level. So this is a machine heat management system, a frugal approach. Ultimately, we are making a noble way of lightning fast electricity generation device. In just 2.5 minutes, we will give you an electricity of 11 volts continuously. Thank you. We all pledge to follow green good deeds. We are all a green scientist too. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.